Welcome. Today I am going to talk about censored and truncated models, or topic and truncated models. Main objective of this video is to explain the concept censored and truncated model. Basically, these are used to find a relationship of a censored continuous dependent variable with other variables. Variable is called censored, right or left, lower or upper, when cases with a value at or above some threshold value, take threshold value, while actually it might also be a higher or lower. In left sensing, it means sensing from below. Right sensing, sensing from above. So, in right sensing, values which fall at or above some threshold are censored. Truncation is different than censoring. In truncation, we don't observe values below a certain value. Those values are discarded. In the censored model, there are data, for example, in censored model, there are data on buyers and non-buyers. So, in truncation, from sales data, from sales tax records, what we'll find? We'll find truncated data, because non-buyers will not be included in sales tax record. So, non-buyers will be included in censored data, but they will not be included in truncated data. So, similarly, when we say that we measure income of households per month and we record all values above rupees 2000, for example, 200,000 rupees per month, any household having value income more than that will be recorded as 200,000 rupees. It means we have censored, whereas in we have data on other variables for that particular individual or household. Whereas in truncated model, all values, all variables data will be discarded whose incomes were recorded to rupees 200,000 or more. So, what are its examples? So, you see, you have a number of examples, as I mentioned, that buyers and non-buyers, some consumers spend positive amounts, some consumers don't spend. Labor economics, married women, labor supply, with some women choosing not to work 0 hours, and others choosing to work a positive number of hours. When you send invitation cards for birth party, for marriage ceremony, even these days for online teaching, you will have some capacity, maximum capacity. Above that, where the data are discarded, you can't send invitations more than that. So maximum tickets sold. So in that case, you cannot have more people in that. Similarly, example of income, a central bank. Yeah, that's another example from economics. You see central banks intervene. There is dirty floating exchange rate. They will not allow exchange rate to fall below a certain threshold value or it go above a certain value. So the data will be censored both from right and from left. Dividends will be paid by a company if its earning reaches a certain threshold value. Similarly, we can have only survey of working women. Non-working women are discarded. In such situations, you have data where you have observations on a certain latent variable, and that data is not actual observation. Rupees 200,000 per month, more than that will be recorded as rupees 200,000. Similarly, a student who is scoring 800 on a scale from 200 to 800 will not have the same aptitude as the other one who is scoring 800. So anyone who is scoring 800 will be, above that value, you will not have any observation. Similarly, we'll apply here Amrose data discussed in chapter 17 of Woolrich econometrics book. So now you see that most of the women are 43% of the women observed are not in labor force. So you will see a high peak at 0 point. In such a case, OLS application will provide you inconsistent, will provide you wrong estimates. So you see, you have more values here at 0 hours. So 0 working hours, you have 43% women. So if you'll apply simple OLS, this will give you misleading results. This will give you misleading results. So in order to avoid these misleading results, we apply either censored model and if data truncated, means you don't have data on any of the variable below or above a certain value, then that is called truncated. So in this case, we can apply Tobit model, you can use SenseReg, that is a package used in R, or you can say Tobit, and we have this data, and you have no estimates. If you apply in place of Tobit, you apply LM, you will get quite different results. And in Strata, you can apply this same thing by uploading data, then generating a square variable, and then regressing Tobit model. LL means lower limit is 0. You can have upper limit here. You can have either upper or lower or both. I hope you will have a simple concept and its application. Similarly, you can use trunk regression if you are doing truncated regression. So I hope this will help you in application of censored regression model or Tobit regression model, and situations where you have to apply this censored regression model and Tobit regression model. Thank you for